Hello, welcome. In this short video, let us look at the inverse system of an accumulator. So we are going to derive the inverse system for an accumulator. First, let us look at the definition of accumulator. The output Y of n is equal to the summation m equal to minus infinity to n, that is the current value of x of m. That is, an accumulator basically adds all the values of the input signal up to the current value. For example, if x of m is equal to say something like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, then the value y of n at 2, that is y of 3, is equal to the values 0 plus 1 plus 2, that is the summation from 0 to current value, that is 0 plus 1 plus 2, which is 3. So thus, given an accumulator, we want to find its inverse. An inverse system can be defined as follows. That is, given an input x of n to a system with impulse response h of n, then the output is y of n. And then we give this output as input to the next system with response h2 of n, that is impulse response h2 of n, then the output should be equal to x of n. That is, the input to the first system with the impulse response h of n, the output is y of n. And again, you send the output y of n to another system with impulse response h2 of n, then the output should be equal to the original input x of n. So this is in this case, h2 of n is the inverse system of h of n. Now let us look at the system function, that is y of n is equal to the sum m equal to minus infinity to n x of m. And this summation can be rewritten as, that is, we split the sum as follows, that is summation m equal to minus infinity to n minus 1 x of m plus x of n. That is, we separate the latest value. Now this summation from minus infinity to n minus 1 can be written as y of n minus 1, that is, it is the n minus 1th value of the output y of n. So the current value y of n is equal to the previous value y of n minus 1 plus x of n. That is, we basically add in the new value to the previous sum. That is, we basically update the output y of n with the new value x of n. Or in other words, x of n, that is the latest input x of n, is equal to the difference between the latest output y of n minus the n minus 1th output. That is, the difference between y of n and y of n minus 1 is the current input. We can clearly see that this is the inverse system, that is x of n is equal to y of n minus y of n minus 1. Now we want to look at the impulse response of these two systems. Up to now we have the system equations for the two systems. For the accumulator, we have y of n is equal to the sum from minus infinity to n of x of m. That is, we add all the values of the signal up to the current point, the current index. And for the inverse system, x of n is the difference between the current output and the previous output. Now let us derive the impulse response of the accumulator and also the inverse system. Now in the original system equation, let us use the input x of m as delta of m. That is an unit impulse. Now the impulse response of the accumulator can be defined as h of n is equal to the sum from minus infinity to the current value of delta of m. And clearly the summation is equal to the unit step sequence u of n. This is true because for all values of n greater than or equal to 0, h of n will be equal to 1, which is by definition unit step sequence. Therefore, the impulse response of the accumulator is the unit step sequence. Now for the second system, that is x of n equal to y of n minus y of n minus 1. Let us use y of n is equal to delta of n. Then the impulse response of the inverse system is h2 of n is equal to delta of n minus delta of n minus 1. And clearly this difference is equal to 1 for n equal to 0 and is equal to minus 1 for n equal to 1. Therefore, the impulse response of the accumulator is unit step sequence, and the impulse response of the inverse system of accumulator is, or the difference system is, the difference between delta of n and the delta of n minus 1. That is the unit impulse shifted by one value. Let us look at the block diagram of these two systems. So x of n goes through the first system, whose impulse response is u of n, that is the unit step sequence, and then the output y of n goes through a system whose impulse response is the difference between delta of n and delta of n minus 1. And the final output is equal to the original input x of n. We can also observe that the second system, the inverse system x of n, can be defined as the first difference between the current output and the previous output. Therefore, the difference delta of n minus delta of n minus 1, that is the system characterized by this unit impulse response, is the inverse system of the system with impulse response equal to u of n, that is unit step sequence. Thanks for watching.